Hi, I'm George Pearson, and we'll be doing this Photoshop Elements brush effect portrait. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. You can support this channel through Patreon. Don't forget to subscribe. I do a bunch of videos each week. There's my current schedule. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements, and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. We'll be starting off this Photoshop Elements brush effect with just a regular picture like this. Now, this is a real easy technique, but there's a lot of variability in it. You can have a lot of fun with this. So here's our image on the background layer. I just open up the image like that. Now go up here and click on the new layer mask or add layer mask button. Makes a new layer mask. Also notice that it converts this into a regular layer and no longer into a background layer. Now click on the new layer button. Drag this layer underneath that layer, just like that. Clear down here and then our picture up here with the layer mask. Make sure you're on this bottom layer. Set your colors here to white and then grab the paint bucket, click inside any place that fills that bottom layer with white. Now go up to the layer up here. This is your layer mask. Look for your light blue outline right there. Change your color, your foreground color here to black, and click the paint bucket again. That fills that layer with black. So what this does is the black is now hiding this whole thing and we're seeing the white underneath. We can now show the image here by painting white onto this layer mask. That's the whole idea behind this. We'll go here to the paintbrush and on the brush settings down here, click on that arrow that brings up your brushes. I have mine set at default brushes. If I pull this up quite a ways, there you go. There's your standard default brushes. I'll just roll down here with the wheel on my mouse. And it's down a little ways past halfway point. There's about the halfway point. So a little ways past that, we begin getting into these things here. These are chalk brushes. And I kind of like this one here. It says chalk 36 pixels. That's kind of a nice brush. And then the 36 pixels is the size. Change the size to 300. So you get a good big brush like that. Now change your foreground color to white. There it is. Now if I just tap on here, you can see what happens. You can actually see through this layer mask because of that white on there. I have my opacity down here set at about 44%. That way if I go a few times here, it overlaps and it gets richer where the overlap is. Now if you tap, you get a little bit of texture showing through like that. If you drag, it becomes more solid. That's all you have to do is come in here and just drag it around a little bit. Do a few touches, like, you know, click and drag, let go, click and drag, let go, click and drag, let go. The reason I'm doing that is when you do it that way and you click and drag and then let go and then come back again, you get these overlapping areas in there. That adds interest into the image. And I'll just pull out just some basic ones out like this, kind of streaky things. There we go. And that's really all there is to it. You can finish off right around the face if you want to, a little more detail in there, just kind of go over that several times, and it gets a real solid effect. So we have this nice transition happening here from real solid in the middle out to more overlap of thinner areas out there. If you want to have some texture showing, just go over here to the styles. Go back for a second on the layers. If you want to have some texture showing in here on your brush strokes, just change up here on the layer. Double click on the image side. Look for that light blue outline. There it is. Now come down to styles and you should be seeing bevels up here. It's the top option. You should be seeing that already. Just click on the first bevel right there. And that should give you a little bit of edges showing. You can kind of see them right up in there. A little bit of edges showing. Just a little bit more detail that way on that. So there it is. That's all there is to it. It's pretty easy, as you can see, to come in and create this very interesting kind of brush stroke effect pretty quickly using just a brush stroke and some basic layer mask work. Once you're at this point, you can put a bit more control in here by adding an adjustment layer onto this layer. Go up to Layer, come down to New Adjustment Layer and Levels right there. where it says use previous layer, just check that checkbox and choose OK. Now you can control the values of your picture with your slider controls. The middle one is all your midtones, and then the left one are your dark tones, and the right one is your light tones. So it gives you a bit of control in here on your image. I think on this one, going just a little bit darker helps, and about 0.87. Just a bit more richness in there on that. So there you go. Real fast, real easy, kind of a brushstroke technique to work on your portraits. The last thing I want to mention here, for this to work out well and get a nice effect, let me just come up here and let's disable the layer mask just for a minute. There we go. The one thing I found that does help is composition-wise, you want to have the face kind of in the middle of the picture. So you have a lot of space above, below, and left and right. That gives you space for your brush strokes to work. If you have a very large face, then you're going to run out of area with your brush strokes very quickly, and you'll see hard edges. So a picture where you have more background showing and the face is more towards the middle of the image will give you some room in here for the brush strokes to show. Okay, let's put that back up again. There we go. Okay, there it is. There is the brush stroke layer mask effect, and you can get different effects, different qualities in here just by choosing different brushes. And there are all kinds of brushes to choose from. Just play around with these things. Just try different stuff and think you get some really interesting effects. And there's also, of course, in here lots of other brush styles or brush sets as well that come pre-included here with Photoshop Elements. All right, there you go. That is the brush effect in here for portraits.